Köszöntöm Önöket a CU 25. e fordulóját ünneplő koncerten. Welcome to this musical celebration of the 25th anniversary of Central European University. We have just this morning celebrated our 25th commencement, graduating 692 students who join our 14,000 alumni in 129 countries around the world. So would you please join me in a round of applause for our new graduates, many of whom are here. I'm very pleased to see a full house in this beautiful and historic hall. Students, faculty, staff, alumni, trustees, friends, and supporters who join us to celebrate this milestone in CEU's history. I want to especially thank our board chairman, Leon Botstein, for conceiving, and soon you will see implementing, this wonderful idea of tonight's concert with a program that reflects the roots of CEU in Budapest, in Central Europe, and in the United States. I will now ask a dear friend of CEU, who also joined us at our 20th anniversary, to greet you before the program. Please join me in welcoming András Bata, former rector of the Liszt Academy.
Dear President John, Maestro Leon, Mr. Ignatiev, dear faculty and students, distinguished guests. The genius Lotzi and the festive occasion inspired me to give a short speech in musical form. Introduction, Andante Cantabile. I had the honor to share some thoughts at the very first opening ceremony of John's presidential term in the academic year 2009-10. It was a great harmony between my wishes and the later reality. I wished him at the time much success in his new job. This has come 100% true. Theme, Allegro con Brio. Expressing John's personality and skills as president of the CEU. After the great cultural and educational leader Yehuda Elkanah, it may have been difficult to find a successor. I think John, coming from a different historical and professional background, was a very good choice for CEU. The main issues, global thinking, humanity, deep democratic roots, were similar. John is for me the personification of human rights who led us with a sure hand in the labyrinth of paragraphs to the true meaning of love. Variation one, first variation, Allegro Giocoso. It was in winter in the 2014-15 academic year at a cold and wet evening. I was sitting in my car and wanted to cross the Cambridge. Suddenly, there appeared on the former Roosevelt, today Széchenyi Square, a tall man with his very characteristic hat. It was John doing fast steps, exhausted, like the busy rectors all over in the world. I had a sense of déjà vu. I saw myself some years earlier, also hasty steps, also exhausted, up to the ears in a great building project, but without a hat. And now we are here in the nicely reconstructed Temple of Hungarian Music, and some miles away, the new campus of CEU grows, two bastions of the Hungarian and international high education. Second variation, Lento. Two buildings in Budapest and more bridges between two excellent institutions. The idea of George Soros and his fellow founders for the CEU in the 1980s and the conception of Ferenc Liszt and his fellows about 120 years earlier was in fact surprisingly quite similar. The international thinking, the acceptance of different cultures, the idea to develop for a closed and old-fashioned society to a flexible democratic community were guiding stars at the birth of the Liszt Academy and of the CEU as well. This was one of the key points why we celebrated the 200th anniversary of Lisbeth with the 20-year-old CEU in the National Theatre in Budapest, at which Maestro Botstein conducted compositions of Liszt and Gustav Mahler. Third variation, Vivace. Unlike Hungarian music, unlike the Hungarian language, music is a language understood by everybody. In the big choir of nations, small Hungary has an important part. We Hungarian musicians communicate also with CEU mainly through music. In that field, Maestro Botstein was and is an important link in the chain, not to forget his school, Bard College, with its many shared alumni like Classicus Ensemble of Young Musicians in residence at CEU, presenting special musical highlights. Final and Stretta, prestissimo. CEU and Liszt Academy both were created in and for Central Europe. I am convinced that this area is one of the most exciting places in the world. First of all, in terms of cultural heritage, the diversity of tradition and the people, within a smaller frame and scope, a very special place, just like musical notes. You must go behind every cell of melodies, every rhythm shape, to discover the real context, to understand how these people sing, how these countries work. This is the task in the musical field of the Liszt Academy and in the social field of the CEU. Rules and freedom, law and humanity must move together in life and art as well. This is maintained by the founder, Yehuda, Leon, John, the faculty and students as well, and will be continued by the newly elected president, Michael Ignatieff. Dear John, thank you for your friendship, for your contribution, for your efforts in Budapest for this region. I congratulate you and I wish you much success for your further career and happiness in your family life. And I wish CEU and his new leader the same success. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
citizens, we cannot escape history. That is what he said. That is what Abraham Lincoln said. Fellow citizens, we cannot escape history. We of this Congress and this administration will be remembered in spite of ourselves. No personal significance or insignificance can spare one or another of us. The fiery trial through which we pass will light us down in honor or dishonor to the latest generation. We, even we here, hold the power and bear the responsibility. Born in Kentucky, raised in Indiana, and lived in Illinois. And this is what he said. This is what Abe Lincoln said. The dogmas of the quiet past are inadequate to the stormy present. The occasion is piled high with difficulty, and we must rise with the occasion. As our case is new, so we must think anew and act anew. We must disenthrall ourselves, and then we shall save our country. When standing erect, he was 6 feet 4 inches tall, and this is what he said. He said, "It is the eternal struggle between two principles, right and wrong, throughout the world. It is the same spirit that says, you toil and work and earn bread, and I'll eat it, no matter in what shape it comes. Whether from the mouth of a king who seeks to bestride the people of his own nation and live by the fruit of their labor, or from one race of men as an apology for enslaving another race, it is the same tyrannical principle." Lincoln was a quiet man. Abe Lincoln was a quiet and a melancholy man. But when he spoke of democracy, this is what he said. He said, "As I would not be a slave, so I would not be a master. This expresses my idea of democracy. Whatever differs from this, to the extent of the difference, is no democracy." Mm-hmm. Abraham Lincoln, 16th President of these United States, is everlasting in the memory of his countrymen. For on the battleground at Gettysburg, this is what he said. He said that from these honored dead, we take increased devotion to that cause for which they gave the last full measure of devotion. That we here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain, and that this nation under God shall have a new birth of freedom, and that government of the people, by the people, for the people, shall not perish from the earth.
Thank you. Thank you.